So how did Julian Assange end up in this position in the UK, where he's the subject of delicate international negotiations? Well, he was born in Australia, of course, which means he holds Australian citizenship, and this is where he set up WikiLeaks. Now, in 2010, while in Sweden on a speaking trip, he was arrested over alleged rape and sexual assault. Now, he travelled to the UK in December of that year, where he remained since then on bail, fighting extradition orders to Sweden, where he would face those charges. Now, he's applied for political asylum at Ecuador's embassy because he fears that if he is sent to Sweden, it may then lead him to being sent to the United States, where he would face charges over WikiLeaks, for which he could face the death penalty. Well, Julian Burnside, QC, is one of Australia's leading human rights lawyers. I spoke to him earlier. Why did Julian Assange choose the Ecuadorian embassy?
Well, the Ecuadorian government has been friendly towards him, unlike our government and the US government. And I suppose that he has some connection with them. It does seem like a curious choice at first glance, but I understand that the president of Ecuador is well disposed to Assange.
Ecuador does have an extradition agreement with the United States. Why would he feel safe to go there?
My guess is that he thinks that they would not extradite him to the United States. And quite frankly, they shouldn't extradite him to the United States, because so far as anyone knows, he has not committed any offence against any law of the United States.
Why do you think that the Australian government has not fully supported him? Our government says that they have afforded him full consular assistance.
Yeah, the government says that. On the other hand, when they are asked directly whether they have inquired of the Americans what the Americans have in mind for Assange, they conspicuously refuse to answer that question. And that suggests to my mind that they know that the Americans want to get their hands on Assange for their own reasons.
But there are governments that think that he has done the wrong thing. Our own Prime Minister has implied that he's guilty.
Yeah, she was wrong.
But has that created a difficult situation for our government in terms of what to do to support him?
Oh, I don't think they'd have too much trouble walking away from that, but I suspect that the closeness of our relationship with America is more of a source of difficulty. I imagine that the Prime Minister and the Foreign Minister know exactly what the Americans want and don't want to stand in their way.
If he's not guilty of anything, why then is he scared of going to the United States and facing the courts?
Well, look what the United States have been doing to Bradley Manning. You know, he has been held in solitary confinement, naked for a substantial part of the time, for 2 years, whilst he's been awaiting his trial. Now, you know, it seems that he may be in some real difficulty, given what he did, but they have mistreated him shamefully. Now, it doesn't matter whether Assange has committed an offence or not, he can be guaranteed to be badly treated by the Americans if they get their hands on him. Now, I suspect that the reason Manning is being treated the way he has been is that they're trying to sweat him to get him to implicate Assange, which he has conspicuously not done.
There are some US politicians who've talked openly about executing Julian Assange. Is that, do you think, a likely outcome if he is extradited there?
It's something which is sufficiently serious a threat that our government ought to be taking real steps to protect him from it. We know that the Americans are involved in extrajudicial killings, in particular by the use of drones. When high-placed people in America say that Assange ought to be assassinated, that's something that people really do need to take seriously, because if some CIA operative doesn't do it, some loony from the right may do it, and no Australian citizen should be exposed to that sort of risk.
Julian Burnside, thanks very much for your time tonight.
Thank you.